I am Dr. K. Chandrasekhar Reddy, obtained B.Tech and Ph.D. from Sri Venkateswara University, Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh, India. M.Tech from National Institute of Engineering, Mysore. My specialization, Water Source Engineering. I have more than 20 years of experience in teaching and industry. I taught both B.Tech and M.Tech students. Have published numerous technical papers in national and international reputed journals and has taken part in several national and international conferences and workshops. In the design and drawing of irrigation structure, 8th topic, siphon well drop. First of all, we'll see what is a drop, canal drop, or it is also called canal fall. It is a solid masonry or concrete structure constructed on the canal if the natural ground slope is steeper than the designed canal bed slope. From this it is clear a canal drop, a drop fall that provided in a canal whenever the designed slope is differs from natural ground slope will construct the canal drop or canal fall. If not constructed that pukka structure, if a fall will be allowed because all the canal, entire length of the canal is made up of the soil, it may be eroded. In order to prevent it, canal drops are mandatory in the case of falls. The various types of canal falls, depending on the ground level conditions and shape of the fall, they are classified as wogie fall, stepped fall, vertical fall, rapid fall, straight glacis fall, trapezoidal notch fall, well or cylindrical type notch fall. It is also called siphon well drop. That is the designed to be taken in this Montagu type fall and English or baffle fall. This is the siphon well drop. There are two wells on the upstream side and another well on the downstream side. What is coming from here, from the canal? Here we have to provide a fall and it will be once again joining to the downstream side of the canal. In between that there is a structure which will be constructed. This type of fall we call it as a siphon well drop. Here upstream side well, this well we call it as a upstream side well, this well we call it as a downstream side well. In between these two there is a conduit. Water will be falling on the upstream side well and it will be passing through the conduit and it will be entering into the downstream well. From the downstream well it will be allowed to the downstream side of the canal. Trapezoidal notch, here we will provide the trapezoidal notch. This is the water level in the inlet well. And inlet well, it is also called inlet well or upstream well. Hume pipe or siphon barrel, or it is also called a conduit. This is the downstream side well. A siphon well drop, it consists of, as we discussed earlier, an inlet well with a pipe at its bottom carrying water from the inlet well to downstream side well or a cistern. Instead of downstream side well, we may construct cistern also. The water falls into the inlet well. Here the water falls into the inlet well. Through a trapezoidal notch constructed in the side wall of the well. Here the trapezoidal notch constructed in the side wall of the well. The notch will regulate the flow into the well. It will regulate the flow that is entering into the well. And also maintain proper supply level in the canal upstream. And also here this level should be maintained. Otherwise if you are supplying water from this canal to the irrigation field, if the level is not maintained, the water may not reach the remote point of the agriculture field. The inlet well also acts as energy dissipator by creating water cushion in the inlet well. Initially, when the water is fallen, it will be rises. Because of this water cushion, if water is falling from upstream side to downstream side, it will create some energy. In order to dissipate that energy, this water cushion will be helped to dissipate this energy. So it is act as a energy dissipator, upstream side well. The downstream well, as shown in the figure, this is the downstream well, is necessary in the case of discharges greater than 0.29 cubic. If the discharge is more than 0.29 cubic meters per second, this downstream side well is required. Otherwise, directly allow into downstream side of the canal. We can directly allow into the downstream side of the canal without this downstream side well. Design a siphon well drop crossing a cart track with the following data. because all these structures are constructing in rural area, we club these drops with the cart track. Hydraulic particulars of the canal above the drop. Full supply discharge 0.3 meter cube per second. Bed width 1.25 meters. Bed level 20.00. Full supply depth 0.6 meters. Full supply level 20.60. Top of bank 1 meter wide at level 21.60. Hydraulic particulars of the canal below drop. Full supply discharge same. Whatever the discharge coming from the upstream side, same discharge will be allowed into the downstream side of the canal also. 0.3 meter cube per second. Bed width, same bed width, 1.25, here 1.25. Bed level, it is 19.00. Full supply depth, 0.6 meter. Full supply level, 19.60. As usual, all these values in the mentioned in the bracket, it is for your homework. Now we will discuss about the design using these values. Top of bank, 1 meter wide at level, that is on both upstream and downstream, plus 20.60. Good soil is available for foundation at 19.00. Both upstream and downstream, there are 1 meter wide berms at ground level, inside canal section. The side slopes of canal section in cutting is 1:1 and embankment is 1.5:1. The cart track is 5 meters wide at level 20.50, and this may be assumed as the general ground level. So the ground level and the cart level both are at the same level. Provide 1 meter wide catch drains on both the sides of cart track. The purpose of catch drain is whenever the rain fallen, that will be catched by this drain and it will be carried safely. Good soil for foundation is available at 19.00. This is the data given. You have to draw to a suitable scale, off planet top and off planet foundation. Off sectional elevation. Longitudinal section, that is the cross section through the drop wall. I think many of you are not aware of what is the cart. It is most common in the villages. These are the some of the types of the carts that people are using in the villages to carry the goods and to carry the transport the men. The various components to be designed. Velocity of flow in the barrel. How much of the velocity that will be passing through the barrel. This is the barrel. From upstream side well to entering into the barrel and it will be coming out. What is the velocity of flow in this barrel? Cart track section between the wells. This is the cart track section. There should be a roadway and catch drains on both the sides and side banks in between the, this is the cart track, this is the cart track section between the wells. Head causing flow in the barrel, how much of the head? Suppose if they have maintained minimum head, then only it will drive the flow from upstream to downstream side and will be positive way. That is called head causing flow in the barrel. Trapezoidal notch, we already discussed it. A trapezoidal notch on the side of the well. Here we are providing a trapezoidal notch. And what are its dimensions of the notch? Dimensions, what is the base width of the notch and what is the angle, side angle. That is the dimensions of notch. Upstream well, the design of upstream side well. What is the thickness of the upstream side well? What is the diameter of the upstream side well? Where the foundation will be kept, what is the height of the well, all will come under the upstream well, design of upstream well. Downstream well, in the similar way, where can you put the foundation concrete for this well, what is the depth of this well, in this side height will be different, this side different side height will be different, what is the height in roadside, what is the height in the canal side. This way we should design the downstream well. Syphon barrel, this is the syphon barrel. These are all made up of the RC Hume pipes. The Hume pipes are available in different lengths and different size, standard sizes in the market. Based on that, the dimensions, sizes of the Hume pipe and length, we should design the length, the distance between upstream well and downstream side well. Next one, protection works. because the water is coming from canal to the upstream well, from downstream well to the canal, there may be possibility of erosion. In order to prevent that erosion, provide the protection work on the upstream side and downstream side of the well. The first component to be designed as velocity of flow in the barrel. Discharge in the canal, it is given in the data, 0.3 meter cubed per second, assuming one row of RCC hume pipe with a diameter of 500 mm. How we choose this diameter of the 500 mm? Diameter of RCC hume pipes available in the market, these are the standard dimensions are available in the market. We should choose the near one which we needed. Here 80 mm, 100 mm, 150 mm, 200, 225, 250, 300, 350, 400, 450, 500, like that, up to 1800 mm diameter of the RC hume pipes are available. In our case, we initially assumed 500 mm as the diameter of the barrel. We substitute in this area of the barrel, A equal to pi d square by 4. Pi d square is 500 mm, that is 0.5 meter. Then you can get the area of 0.196 square meters. Now we find out what is the velocity in the barrel. Therefore, velocity in the barrel V equal to Q by A, discharge by area. Discharge is 0.3 meter cubed per second. Area is 0.196 meter square. So 0.3 divided by 0.196, 1.53 meters per second. It is less than the permissible velocity, hence it may be adapted. Otherwise, suppose if it is not satisfied, then you change the diameter of the pipe and once again recheck it. What is the permissible velocity? A permissible velocity of flow in the siphon barrel is 2 to 3 meters per second. It should not be more than 3 meters per second. That is the permissible limit. Here we got only 1.53. So it is less than 3 meters per second. Hence safe. You may be adopt the same diameter. The second component in this design, cart track section between the wells. This is the upstream side well, this is the downstream side well, below that conduit, siphon barrel. This is the roadway. This we call it as a cart track. It is 5 meters. The level of this cart track is 20.50. And this side, this is the side drains. This is also a side drain with 1 meter width. This width is 1 meter, this width is 1 meter. The level of the side drain is 20.0. Here also the level of the side drain is 20.0. This slope 1.5:1 and this level is 21.6. This side also same 1.5:1 is the side slope and this level is 20.6 and the level of the upstream side well, top level of the upstream side well is 20.0. The level of the upstream side well is 22.0. Here it is called upstream side well. The thickness, this is the wall thickness only we have shown. This side the well. So one side wall thickness is 0.45 meters thick wall. Here also we have shown the left side of the well, wall of the well, downstream well. It is 0.45 meters thick well. Now we find out how much is the distance between the upstream well and downstream side, so that we can choose the pipes, conduits in between the upstream well and downstream side well to transport the water from, allow the water to from upstream side to downstream side. Length of the pipe required, let us consider from here to here, that is x. First one, this distance is 0.45. This distance is a bund, 2 meters width. This is a bund of 2 meters width, then 2. Next, this level difference is 21.6 minus 20 into the slope is 1.5. So, this is the length from here to here. Next, width of the drain is 1 meter from here to here, 1 meter. Now, we want to this distance from here to here. How can we get this distance? This level 20.5 minus 20 into slope is 1 plus the width of the road, that is a roadway or cart track, 5. This is 5 from here to here, 5 plus I want to know this distance. This 20.5 minus 20. This slope is also 1 is to 1. Here this slope is 1 is to 1. 20.5 minus 20 into 1 plus the width of the drain 1 meter plus this level 20.6 minus 20. I want to find out the distance from here to here. 20.6 minus 20 into this slope also 1.5 is to 1 into 1.5 plus this is the bund. Bund width is 2 meters plus now we want to know this distance. How can we know this distance? 20.6 minus 20. This slope also 1 is to 1. Here it is not mentioned. This slope also 1 is to 1. 20.6 minus 20 into 1 into 1. Plus this width, thickness of the wall 0.45. Here it is missed. This slope is 1 is to 1. This slope is 1.5 is to 1. This slope is 1 is to 1. From all these considerations, if we solve this 0.452 and this value 2.4 and this 1 and from this 0.5 plus 5 from this 0.5 from this 1 from this 0.9 from this 2 from this 0.6 from this 0.45. You sum up all these distances, you get x equal to 16.8 meters. From this point to this point, that is the length of the siphon barrel, should be 16.8 meters. Now, head causing flow, that is the loss of head in the barrel, or we can call it as head driving flow from this side to this side. That is, suppose this is the inlet well, it is also called upstream well, upstream side water level, and this is the downstream side water level. The difference between these two, we call it as a head causing flow or loss of head. How can you find out this head? Head required to drive the flow through the barrel from upstream well to downstream side well, that we indicated it as a small h. By using Unwin's formula, according to him, h equal to 1 plus f1 plus f2 into L by R whole into v square by 2g. Of course, here we are neglecting the velocity of approach. Otherwise, we can get plus velocity va square by 2g. That term we neglected here. Where h is the head causing flow, that is the loss of head. L length of the barrel, previously we calculated from this point to this point, that is the length of the barrel in terms of meter. R is the hydraulic mean radius of the barrel, R equal to A by P, area by wetted perimeter. V, velocity of flow through the barrel in terms of meters per second. F1, coefficient of head loss at entry depends on mouth shape of the barrel. That depends upon shape of this mouth of the barrel. F2, coefficient which accounts for friction in the barrel, because it is a pipe through which when water flowing, there is a friction of the side of the barrel, that equal to A into 1 plus 0.3 B by capital R. Where A and B are the constants, depends on type of pipe material. Which type of material we are using, that depends A and B values. R value same as that of the hydraulic mean radius. Now substitute in this all this equation. Head causing flow H equal to 1 plus F1 plus F2 into L by R into V square by 2. That equal to 1 plus F1 0.505 plus F2 0.0039 into L 17.5. There we have calculated 16.8, but if you observe here, we are getting 17.5. No doubt 16.8 is sufficient, but with that length, the standard pipes in the market that are not available. That is why we chosen 17.5 by R, hydraulic mean radius 0.13 into velocity 1.53. We already calculated 1.53 square by 2 into 9.81. Then the head causing flow equal to 0.24 meters. How these values we got, A, B, all, you please refer this one. F1 is the barrel entrance coefficient. For unshaped mouth, suppose if that this is unshaped mouth, then it is 0.505. If it is a bell-mouthed, we should assume 0.08, because we consider that is an unshaped mouth, that is why we took 0.505 as the F1 value. Here F1 value 0.5. Next, F2 value. F2, how can we calculate? A into 1 plus 0.3 B by R. A, B values. It all already we discussed. A and B are depends upon the type of material. Suppose if it is smooth iron pipe, A value, B value, these are the A and B values. Suppose if encrusted iron pipe, these are the AB values. If you assume, or if you took smooth cement pipe, this is the value 0.00316 and 0.10. Suppose if it is a pipe material, ashlar brick work, then these are the AB values. If you took rubble masonry or stone pitching, A and B values are, these are the A and B values. In our case, we adopted a smooth cement pipe, that is why we took A equal to 0.00316 and B 0.10. And F1, we assumed it is an unshaped mouth, that is why we took 0.505. We substitute all these values in this. And F1, F2 equal to A into 1 plus 0.3 B by R. From this, if you substitute, and finally, we calculate 0.0039. This we obtained assuming a smooth cement pipe. That is why we substitute that values and we got F2. L length 17.5. Why we took instead of 16.8, 7.5? Because the pipe sizes are available. The standard size is 2.5 meters. So the pipes available in the market only in terms of 2.5. Suppose if you take 6 pipes, 6 into 2.5, it is less than 16.8. So it is not suitable. The next way possible is only 7 pipes of each 2.5, because 2.5 meters is the standard length of the pipe that is available in the market. That is why we took 7 into 2.5, that is 17.5 meters. So, which is more than 16.8 as per the previous calculation. Now, the question is, actually it is 16.8, but it is a 17.5, where that distance will be adjusted. You subtract from 17.5 to minus 16.8, that value divided by 2, and provide the same sides with the same width. Then we can adjust L equal to 17.5 meter. You please remember the standard pipes that are available in the market is in terms of 2.5. That is why we have chosen 7 and 17.5. If less than this, it may be less than this. That is the reason we took 7 pipes of each 2.5, 17.5 meter. R equal to hydraulic radius. A by P, area by wetted perimeter. That for a circular section, it becomes a D by 4. And substitute, you can get R value. We calculated velocity of flow in the siphon barrel, 1.53 meters per second. Now, we substitute all these values in this, and we obtained this F2 value. And we substitute F2 value, and we got 0.4 meters. Therefore, this is the head causing flow. Then, water level in the upstream side well. That is, full supply level of the downstream side well plus head causing flow. If you see here, that H where this level, we want to find out this level. How can we find out this level? Full supply level in the downstream side plus head causing flow H. Then we can fix up this level, water level in the upstream side well. That equal to full supply level of downstream side well plus head causing flow 19.6 plus 0.24. That equal to 19.84, that is the level of water in the upstream side. Next one, the design of trapezoidal notch. Sill of the notch here. This is the sill of the notch plus 20, which is greater than 19.84 with water level in the upstream well. Previously we calculated how much is the water level in this 19.84. This is the 19.84. This is the 20. If it is more than this, what will happen? It will be submerged arpipe and there is a reverse flow. It is always, the water level always should be less than this of the sill of the notch. This is the sill of the notch. This is the water level in the well. This always should be less than the sill of the notch. Here it is 20.00. It is 19.84. So, the water level in the upstream side well is 19.84. It is more than 20, hence we can adopt a notch, discharges freely. Otherwise, it is a submerged notch. It is a combination of triangular and rectangular notch. A trapezoidal notch is a combination of this, you see, triangular portion. If you see here, this is the triangular portion. You take this as the rectangular portion. So a trapezoidal notch is a combination of triangle. These two mix it together, we can take one triangle, and this we take it as one rectangular. So it is a combination of triangular and rectangular notch. The discharge through a trapezoidal notch equal to discharge through the triangular portion plus discharge through the rectangular portion. The discharge equation for triangular section 8/15 CD root 2g tan theta by 2 h to the power of 5/2 plus discharge through the rectangular portion 2/3 CD L root 2g h to the power of 3/2. This is the h. We know the h, but we don't know what is a L, what is a theta by 2. Or if both theta by 2 club together, we know theta. It comes theta. There are two unknowns. What are the unknowns? L and theta. Here only one equation. But to solve two unknowns, we need two equations. How can we get two equations? Assuming CD equal to 0.7, coefficient of discharge 0.7, go for two equations. The first equation we obtained using full supply discharge, that is Q equal to 0.3 meter cube per second, and full supply depth, it is given 0.6 meters. You substitute all these values in this equation, 0.3, and you substitute all this equation, you can get an equation in terms of L and theta. Let us call this as the first equation. So this way we can get one equation in terms of L and theta. Next equation we can get for half supply discharge. The total discharge is 0.3, half of that discharge is 0.3/2, 0.15 meter cube per second. We want to know half supply depth. Here we take the half supply depth is 3/4 of the full supply depth, that is 0.45 meter. So half supply depth is 0.45 meter, half supply discharge is 0.15 meter. We substitute in this equation, we can get the another equation in terms of L and theta. You call it as a equation number 2. By solving equations 1 and 2, because 2 unknowns, 2 equations. Now we solve this 1 and 2 equation, we get theta by 2 equal to 30 degrees, 32 minutes, and L equal to 0.025 meter, 2.5 centimeters. Of course, we may adopt minimum of 3 centimeters. The dimensions of the notch, dimensions in the sense, base width, and the angle and top width and height. The width of the notch at sill at level of 20, that is the level of the sill notch 20, this width is 3 cm. The width of the notch at full supply level, this is the full supply level, at 20.6 is the full supply level. Here this width, how can you find out this width? This width plus based on this angle. This type of, if we extend here one portion, if you extend here another portion, that is why two portions, that is why we have taken 2 into 0.6, 10, 0.6 is the height, full supply level height, depth, 0.6 times of 10 of 30 degrees, 32, we substitute, you can get 74 centimeters. These are the dimensions of the notch. Base width is 3 centimeters, top width is 74 centimeters, height is 0.6 meters. Inlet well, now the design of inlet well, how can you design the inlet of well, that is also called upstream side well. In the design means, what is the level, what is the bottom level, what is the height, what is the internal diameter, what is the thickness of the well. The upstream well is a masonry well with internal diameter of 1.25 meter. The internal diameter is 1.25 meter. The top level is slightly above the canal bank. You should always above the canal bank. Slightly above the canal bank, that is about 40 centimeters. Therefore, top level of the canal equal to 21.6 plus 0.4, that equal to 20.0. So, the top level is 22.0. The bottom level of the masonry well may be fixed at 18.6. Here. Below this, a foundation concrete of 60 centimeters thick is provided. So, the bottom level of the well is fixed at 18.6, below that 60 centimeters of foundation concrete, then bottom level of the foundation concrete is 18. Therefore, height of the well, top level of the well minus bottom level of the well, that is 22 minus 18.6, 3.4 meters. So, the height of the well is 3.4 meters. The thickness of the wall of the well should be such that it should resist lateral earth pressure. In this problem, the thickness of the wall assumed as 45 cm. In this case, we assumed the thickness of this well is, if you observe here, 0.45 meters, that is 45 centimeters. Similarly, downstream of the well, the downstream well is a masonry well, it is also a masonry well, with internal diameter same 1.25 meters and thickness also same 0.45 meters, the thickness, both the sides, the thickness is 0.45 meters. The downstream well is such that, the downstream well is such, it has two different heights. Here the height is different, here the height is different, as shown in the figure. The top level of the well for the semicircular portion on the earth side, in the earth side, this is the earth side, 20.0. The top level of the well for the semicircular portion on rear canal bed level, in canal side, it is 19. Here the level is 19.0. The bottom level of the masonry well may be fixed at 17.6. Below this, a foundation concrete of 60 cm thick is provided. Below that, a 60 cm thick of the concrete foundation is laid. So, water will be coming from the sluice barrel to here and it will be passing away through the well and it will be entering into the canal, downstream side of the canal. Syphon barrel. Each RCC U pipe with 50 cm, that is 0.5 meters internal diameter and a length of 2.5 meters is selected. 7 such pipes were selected for a length of 17.5 meters. From here to here, 17.5. Actually, it is 16.8. Now it is 17.5. The difference you adjust in this side and this side. This is the longitudinal section of the siphon well drop. Here, this is the well, upstream side production was notch, foundation concrete, sluice barrel, the each pipe 2.5, 2.5, it will be joined. Here the joint with another, this is the jointing portion, here is also joints, and this is the road track, side drains all, this is the downstream side well, downstream side protection works, this is all about the longitudinal section of the siphon well. Note, 20 cm cone bedding is provided as a support to this barrel over a 15 cm thick sand layer. Below that, if you simply keep it, it may not withstand. Below that, you dig a well and there you put a 15 cm of thick sand layer. Over that, you lay a concrete. Here, if you observe here, you lay the concrete 20 cm and it will be like a cone bedding. This is the way this pipe should be rested so that no damage in the pipe due to flowing of water. Since it is not possible to get a single length of large pipe, joints are provided to make up complete length of the barrel, because it is not a single pipe, it is a number of pipes. If you want to joint it, you should provide the joint. The joints provided are shown below. This is the joint. It is a bell mouthed point. Here it will be inserted and surrounding that the concrete bed may be laid like this. This is the way you should seal this joint and provide a bed concrete like this. And below the pipe, use this pattern to lay the pipes. Protection works. Upstream and downstream side revetment and apron. This is the upstream side protection works. This is the upstream side well. This is the upstream side protection works. The length of the revetment. This is the length of the revetment. Rough stone revetment 30 cm thick, 2 meters. The length of the apron, this we call it as apron, this we call it as a revetment. Same material, same way of construction, but if we keep in the sides of the canal, that we call it as a revetment. If we keep at the bottom of the bed of the canal, that we call it as apron. That is the difference. But the material usage is same in both the cases, but the laying procedure is different from the revetment to the apron. This is the length of the apron, this is the revetment. You provide a 2 meters. Rough stone pitching 30 cm thick, 2 meters. This is the drawing. As usual, draw the central line. This is the central line. From central line, all this will be planned after construction. If you see the aerial view, that is why we call it as a plan at top. From central line, this is the CL. If you observe here, it is a slash L, central line. All this portion will be off-planet foundation. This is the longitudinal section. This is the end view from the upstream side. After construction, if you see from the end view, how it looks. This is the section across BB. If you cut it here, and at the joint, if you see how it looks. If you cut the pipe, and if you see how it looks. This is the cross section of at AA. This is the cross section at B. As usual, you just take the center line. From center line to, we know this distance. You draw this distance and this. And you draw the line. And we know the cart track. 5 meters. You draw the 5 meter. We know the slope. 1:1. With that 1:1, you calculate this distance. Similarly, we know the width of the drain. 1 meter. And we know the slope. This slope. 1.5:1. It is symbol given here. And it's shown that means it is sloping in this direction. Here also, it is sloping in this direction. Here, it is sloping in this direction. That way, you finish up it. These details are given in the design. Berm and slope and next slope, tankman level, all this is given. You know the elevations between these two and we know the slope. Elevation difference into slope, it will give that this distance. That way, you finish up this portion. Once you finish up this portion, you extend it. Then you draw all this line, upstream side well, upstream side protection work, siphon barrel and road track details and downstream side well, downstream side of the production works. All this you draw and you mention the names and give the values. Then you project it from here. Half of that I think you can get by drawing this line. You can get the end elevation. This is the notch. Notch will be continued over that and the sides of the canal and this is the way. Sides of the berm. Top width of the bund and side slopes of the bund. Berm, here the berm, slope and top width of the bund, once again slope, this we can get it. And these details we can get from the design itself. So, this is the inner pipe and its mouth and the outer pipe that will be inserted just like a bell mouth and it will be inserted into the pipe. This pipe will be inserted. This is the divergent diameter and this is the mouth diameter and it will be end to end. Jointed and it will be laid a concrete up like this. The concrete is laid and it is sealed. Here below the pipe, the entire pipe you lay this. Below that 15 cm of sand you filled with 15 cm sand. Above that 20 cm of concrete and it will be up to middle. It should be like cone. One may refer this test book and desktop application you may contact her. So once again, I briefly revise it. Syphon well drop. A canal drop, or it is also called a canal fall. It is a solid masonry or concrete structure constructed on the canal. If the natural ground slope is steeper than the designed canal bed slope, then we will construct the drop. There are various types of the canal falls. Depending on the ground level conditions and the shape of the fall, they are classified as bogie fall, stepped fall, vertical fall, rapid fall, straight glacis fall, trapezoidal notch fall, well or cylinder notch fall, that is also called siphon well drop, Montague fall and English or baffle fall. Now we will discuss about this siphon well drop. This is the siphon well drop. It consists of upstream side well, downstream side well and a siphon barrel. It is also called Hume pipe. This is also called inlet well or upstream well. In the left side of the well, there is a trapezoidal notch. Water coming from the upstream side through the canal and it will be passed through the trapezoidal notch and it will fall on the inlet well. After that, it will pass to the siphon barrel and it reaches the downstream well from the downstream well to downstream side of the canal. A siphon well drop, it consists of an inlet well with a pipe at its bottom carrying water from the inlet well to downstream well or a cistern. The water falls into the inlet well through a trapezoidal notch constructed in the sidewall of the well. The notch will regulate the flow into the well and also maintain proper supply level in the canal system. The inlet well is also act as energy dissipator because once the water is falling, it has huge impact, huge energy. Because of this water storage, that is the water cushion, the energy may be dissipated. Whether this downstream side well required or not, that depends upon how much of the discharge it is passing. If it is more than 0.29 cubics, then we require downstream side well. Otherwise, we can directly allow the water to the downstream side of the canal. Hydraulic design, a siphon well drop consisting a cart track with the following data. These are the hydraulic particles of the canal above the drop, full supply discharge, bed width, bed level, full supply depth, full supply level, top bank 1 meter wide at level. Similarly, hydraulic particles of the canal below the drop, full supply discharge, bed width, bed level, full supply depth and full supply level. These are the additional details regarding the siphon well drop. Usually, it is linked with the cart track. That is a cart track of 5 meters wide at level so and so, and this may be assumed as the general ground level. These are the details given. We have to draw off plan at top and off plan at foundation, that we simply call it as a plan. Off sectional elevation, longitudinal section, that is also called cross section through the drop wall. These are the some of the examples of the carts that we are using. So we should allow the carts to be run along the siphon well drop. These are the various components to be designed. Velocity of flow in the barrel, how much of the velocity that should be allowed in the barrel. Cart track section between the walls, wells, this is the cart section. Hard causing flow in the barrel, how much is the upstream side full supply level minus downstream side full supply level, that gives the head causing flow in the barrel. Trapezoidal notch, here we construct the trapezoidal notch, this is the trapezoidal notch. Dimensions of the notch, dimensions means length and this angle. Upstream well, this is the upstream well, downstream well, this is the downstream well, siphon barrel, this is the barrel, protection work, this is the upstream side protection, downstream side protection. Velocity of flow in the barrel, it is given discharge 0.3. Assuming one row of RCM pipes with a diameter, we should choose the diameter that is available in the market. These are the diameters of pipes that is available in the market. In this case, we choose 500 mm. And the permissive velocity of flow in the siphon barrel, generally it is 2 to 3, but it should not be more than 3 meters per second. Assuming one row of RCM pipes with a diameter of 500 mm, then the area of the barrel equal to pi d square by 4. If substituted, we can get the area. Once we got the area, velocity equal to discharge by area, we got 1.53. It is less than permissive limit 3. Hence, this diameter may be adopted. Otherwise, the diameter may be changed. This is the cart track section between the wells. This is the one side wall of the well. This is the another side of the downstream side well. In between the two wells, the cart track well. Cart track means, this is the roadway. This is the side drains. Bund, here also bund. And upstream well thickness, downstream side well, 5.45 meter thick wall. These are the downstream side well wall. It is the upstream side well wall. In between this, this is the cart track section. If you want to find out the distance from here to here, we should calculate this distance, and from the slope, this distance. This, like that, we calculate it and substitute. You get x equal to 16.8 meters. Head causing flow, that is head causing flow is upstream side full supply level minus downstream side full supply level. That H can be calculated, not upstream side full supply level. It is the water level in the upstream side and downstream side water level. That can be calculated using H equation, Unwin's formula. H equal to 1 plus F1 plus F2 into L by R into V square by 2G. Of course, plus VA square by 2G, that is velocity of approach, that we neglected here. Using this equation, all these values, if you substitute here, you can get the H value. To find out the A, B and F1 value, these are the guidelines. One, you should follow the guidelines. F1 barrel entrance coefficient depends upon shape of the mouth. Here we consider unshaped mouth. Here we consider smooth cement pipe. That is why we took A value and B value. That we substitute in this, you can get. But here one thing, it is given 17.5 instead of 16.8 because the standard length of the pipes that are available in the market is 2.4. If I took 6 pipes, it is less than the 16.8, not suitable. So, I took 7 pipes, 7 into 2.4, 17.5, more than that, then you can add up. But this difference can be adjusted on the left side and right side of the cart track. R equal to hydraulic mean radius, area by wetted perimeter. Because it is circular, it becomes a D by 4. And substituting all this, we can get H value. Water level in the upstream well, full supply of the level of the downstream side well, plus head causing flow 19.84. If you observe here, actually it is a 19.84. This is 19.84, this is 20. So, it is a freely falling notch. Then, the distance through the trapezoidal notch means triangular portion plus rectangular portion. Triangular portion equation is 8 by 15 CD root is 10 theta by 5 by 2. For rectangular, 2/3 CDL root is 3 by 2. substitute all the equations, because two unknowns, L and theta, but we have only one equation. For that, you create two equations. For full supply discharge, full depth, full supply depth, this is the equation. For half supply discharge, half supply depth, this is the equation. Substituting those two, by solving two, we can get L and theta values. This is the dimensions. We know this angle and this width. We know this height, 20.6 minus 23.6. We can find out top width is 74 centimeter. Inlet well. This is the inlet well. Assume internal diameter equal to 1.25 and thickness of the well equal to 0.45. Top level is more than that of the bank. The bank is 21.6 plus minus 22. Fix at 22. And bottom level is 18.6. You can get it. The difference will get the height of 3.4. Similarly, in the downstream well, it is also a circular well with an internal diameter of 1.25 and the thickness is 0.45. Here also, you fix up the top level at 20 and take the bottom of the foundation, bottom well, top of the foundation is 17.6. Here the height is different, here the height is different. The water will be coming in this way and it will be passing away and it enter into the downstream side of the well. Syphon barrel. This is the siphon barrel. Already we discussed 7 pipes with 2.5 meters, but the different pipes can be joined together by means of jointing. This is the process. You can joint that, the joint. And below the pipe, you put, take for 15 centimeters of sand. Over that, you lay this concrete. This is the way. If you see here, this is the way the pipes should be laid. This is the way the pipe should be jointed. Downstream well. Production works. Upstream and downstream side. This is the upstream side production work, downstream side production work. Then the length of the rivetment. This is the length of the rivetment. Length of the stone pitching. It is 2 meters. Similarly, in the downstream side also. This is the plan. This is the longitudinal section. Section at BB. Section at AA. That means if you see this section here, if you see the section here. This is the end view from the upstream side. If you, after construction, if you stand on that and if you see, this is the